Hello dear children, motivation helps us to get started and habits helps us to keep going on. I am Manju, your maths facilitator. Let's stay motivated and habituated to do maths. Today we are going to deal with the chapter 2 of class 6 whole numbers. This would be an introductory video and I would teach you the basic concepts in this particular chapter. In previous classes, you have already learned about numbers, isn't it? What are the different types of numbers? That is, first one is natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, and so on. So, when we begin to count, we use 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Yes? So, it is a counting numbers. In mathematically, we can call it as what? It is a natural numbers. So, natural numbers, it is denoted by the letter what? Capital letter N. So, natural number is also called counting numbers. Okay, why it is called counting numbers? Because it is used for counting. Okay, next one is whole numbers. So, the number 0 is added to the entire set of natural numbers. It is called whole numbers. So, what are the whole numbers? We start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. It is denoted by the letter W. So, natural numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, etc. And it is denoted by the letter capital N. It is also called it as counting numbers. Okay, next one is whole numbers. Count starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. It is denoted by the letter W. Okay. In this chapter, we learn about some specialities or peculiarities about whole numbers. Okay. Let us start from properties of whole numbers. There are 5 properties of whole numbers. First one, closure property. Second, commutative property. Third, associative property. And fourth, distributive property, and the last one is identity property. Let us understand each of the properties of whole numbers one by one. Okay, first one, closure property of addition. When two whole numbers are added, we get always the sum as a whole number. Okay, for example, the number 2 added with 4, we get the result is 6. So, 6 is again a whole number. Okay, the next one is closure property for multiplication. Take two numbers, 2 and 4. 2 multiplied with 4, we get the result is 8. 8 is again a whole number. So, we can conclude when we add two whole numbers, we get the sum again a whole number. When we multiply two whole number, again the product is a whole number. Okay, what about subtraction and division? Let us take two numbers. Okay, 4 and 2. 4 minus 2, what will we get? 2. 2 again a whole number. But 2 minus 4, we get minus 2. Minus 2 is not a whole number. What are the whole number system? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Yes. So, this is does not include minus 2. So, minus 2 is not a whole number. So, we can say that closure property does not holds for subtraction. Okay. The next one is division. 4 divided by 2, we get 2. But 2 divided by 4, we get 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is not a whole number. So, we can say that closure property is holds for addition and multiplication, but does not holds for subtraction and division. Okay. The next property is commutative property for addition, multiplication, subtraction and division. Next property is commutative property. First we check commutative property of addition. Observe that the sum of the whole numbers is the same irrespective of the order of the addends. Let us check through an example. Okay, first we take two numbers 6 and 3. Okay, 6 plus 3 we get the result is 9. Again, we can add in another way 3 plus 6 equal again 9. Okay, so 6 plus 3 equal 3 plus 6 equal 9. Okay, the next one is commutative property for multiplication. The same example 6 and 3, 6 into 3 equal 18 and 3 into 6 again equal 18. Okay, so we can conclude that even if we change the sum or the product, result will be the same. Okay, the next property is what? Commutative property for multiplication and addition. The next is commutative property for subtraction. So, commutative property for subtraction, 6 minus 3 equal what? 3. But 3 minus 6 equal what? Minus 3. So, it is not equal. Okay, so 6 minus 3 not equal to 3 minus 6. What about division? Commutativity of division? 6 divided by 3, we get the answer is 2. Okay, but 3 divided by 6, we get 1 by 2. 2 is not equal to 1 by 2. That is 6 divided by 3 not equal to 3 divided by 6. Okay, so commutative property of addition, multiplication holds, but commutative property in subtraction and division, it is this not holds for whole numbers. Okay, the third property is associative property. Associative property for whole numbers in addition. First we check in addition. Take three numbers, 1, 2, 3. Okay, associative property. So first we check in addition. 1 plus 2 plus 3. First we group the first two numbers. That means 1 plus 2 in one bracket and plus 3 in outside. What will we get? 1 plus 2 equal 3 in outside plus 3. So the final answer is 6. Okay, in another way, 1 plus 2 plus 3 in one bracket. So 1 plus inside the bracket numbers we get 2 plus 3. What will we get? 5. So 1 plus 5 equal 6. Okay, so associate means we can add the numbers in any way. Okay, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 equal 1 plus 2 plus 3. What about multiplication? We take the same number 1, 2 and 3. What are the product of these numbers? First we associate 1 and 2. That means we put in one bracket. Okay, 1 into 2 into 3. Okay, so 1 into 2 equal 2 into 3, we get 6. Next, another way, 1 into 2 into 3. So 2 into 3 in associate in one bracket. So 1 into 6, we get 6. Okay, so 1 into 2 into 3 equal 1 into 2 into 3. We can associate the numbers. That is the associativity of whole numbers. So associativity is holds for addition and multiplication. What about subtraction and division? We take the same number 1, 2 and 3. 1 minus 2, put in one bracket, minus 3. 1 minus 2, we get what? Minus 1, minus 3. The final answer is minus 4. Okay, the next one, 1 minus 2 minus 3 in one bracket, what will we get? 1 minus of minus 1. We get 1 plus 1, 2. So, the first answer is what? Is different from the second. Okay. So, associativity does not holds for subtraction. Okay. Next one is division. Again, we take the same number 1, 2 and 3. 1 divided by 2, 1 by 2 divided by 3 not equal to 1 divided by 2 divided by 3. So, associativity holds for addition and multiplication of whole numbers, but does not holds for subtraction and division. Okay. The next one is distributive property. What is distributive property? From that word, we can distribute one number to another number. Okay. So, first we take 2, 3, 4. Okay, first we take distributive property of multiplication over addition. Okay, so first we take 9 into 6. Okay, so 9 into 6, all of you know that the product is 54. So 9 into 6 can be written as 4 plus 2, isn't it? So that 9 distributed to that two numbers. Okay, that means 9 into 4 plus 9 into 2. Clear? So 9 into 4 put in one bracket and 9 into 2 put in one bracket. 9 into 4, 36 plus 9 into 2, 18. The final answer is 54. You can change 9 also. Okay, 6 into 9 is same as 54. That means we are already studied the commutativity is holds for multiplication. We can multiply the numbers in any order. Okay, so 6 can be written as 4 plus 2, 1 plus 5, that is your convenience. Okay, that is the distributive property of multiplication over addition. But what about distributive property of multiplication over subtraction? It is does not holds because subtraction the sign will be changed. Okay, so distributive property means what? We can distribute one number to into that numbers. Okay, so the distributive property is simplifies your calculation easy. The last one is identity property of addition and multiplication. When 0 added to one number, the answer is the same number itself. Yes, so 0 is called the additive identity for whole numbers. Yes, what about 1 product? That is 1 multiplied with any number, we get the same number. So we can say that 1 is the multiplicative identity for whole numbers. Let us do a quick recap what we have studied till now. What are the things? First, we discuss definition of natural numbers, whole numbers, yes, and the properties of whole numbers. Yes, first one we discuss closure, and the second one is commutative, third one is associative, fourth distributive, and the final is identity property. Okay, hope you all understand what we have studied in this video. See you in next class. Thank you.